Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Matt 170 concept session. Today we're going to be talking about how to solve n-unit growth factors. So, say we're given an equation, and basically what this is saying, the growth of a bacteria, right? This is how a growth of a bacteria is measured, and it's measured in an exponential growth equation, okay? The main thing to focus on here is what this t value means here up in the exponent, and they tell us that t is in weeks. So that is the value that we put in there, right? So like we're looking at the growth of a bacteria across the lines of like 3 weeks, 4 weeks, something like that. But what they're asking us to do here is to convert this equation into an equation where t is in days. Okay, so the way we're going to do this to kind of just start things off is first we want to convert this t so that it's no longer in weeks, that it's in days, right? And the way we can do that is to convert it so that basically what we're going to be thinking of in our equation that I just rewrote is that we're going to think of it as if we're plugging in days for t. So if we divide t by 7, what this will do is essentially, t divided by 7, in this case, actually equals our original t. So it kind of looks a little funky, right? T over 7 equals t. But it just is important because we know that this t is in weeks, and this t is in days. And we know that this is true because if we plug in 7 days, we get 7 over 7, which equals 1, right? Which is 1 week, right? So we're good here, but now what we need to do is address this inside parenthesis here. Now, technically, we're still working with the same equation, right? But what we can do is take this a step further and determine the actual new growth factor of by day. So this is the growth factor by week, right? And the way we can convert that is if we do basically just plug in 1 for t. And the way we'll do this is 3. So this will be our new growth factor equation here. So we have 3, and then the new growth factor, the way we'll calculate that is 1.23 to the power of 1 over 7. So we're just plugging in 1 day, right? And then we'll take this to a power of t. Now, if we solve 1.23 to the 7th, we get an answer of 1.03. So then from here, what we can do is rewrite our equation 3 in parentheses 1.03 to a power of t. And this will be our new equation. Just to kind of reaffirm, this equation that we have here that we just found is equal to what was the original equation given, just that our t now in this new equation is in days instead of weeks. So hopefully that was able to help you out a little bit. Other than that, I hope you have a great rest of your day and good luck in your course. Yeah.